Welcome to the Wheelchair Accessible Vehicle Driver Training Series. In this video, we will cover everything you need to know to prepare your vehicle, pick up and properly secure passengers, end the trip, and get paid. You will be providing an important service for New Yorkers and visitors with all types of disabilities. So there's a lot to know to make sure your passengers are safe, comfortable, and happy. Preparing for the trip. Before you pick up passengers and before you start driving, you'll need to get your vehicle ready for the trip. This video will help you prepare. To get started, make sure to clean your vehicle of extra items so nothing is in the way when you pick up a passenger who uses a wheelchair. By doing this before you go out, you're saving time and money during your shift. Next, locate your seatbelt extenders and rear floor securements so you can get to them easily when helping a passenger. Inspect all of your equipment and make sure that all your belts are in good working order. If you think about it, you wouldn't take your own car out with a flat tire, so don't take your wheelchair accessible vehicle out without working equipment. After checking the belts, place them in a bag you can easily get to. Next, you need to test your front floor securements. But to reach the securements, you need to do a few things first. Use the ramp handhold to pull the ramp out to gain access to the rear passenger area. Then, in the back seat, use the car ignition key to release the shoulder belts so they don't get caught when you fold the seats down. Push down the headrests and fold all the seats down. Pull up the lower seat straps and fold the seats forward. Now you're ready to test the front floor securements. Push the front retractor release button on the wall to release the securements. Then, pull out and retract the securements to make sure that they work properly. Make sure to press the wall button when you finish. Next, test the rear floor securements. Slide them into place on the vehicle floor and make sure they can pull out and retract properly. If you are the owner of your vehicle, please note that it is your responsibility to make sure that all equipment is working before starting your shift. If you are not an owner and have any issues, tell your garage or the vehicle owner so that they can fix the equipment or give you another vehicle for your shift. If you feel like your garage or vehicle owner did not fix the problem, send an email to the TLC's Driver Protection Unit at driverprotection@tlc.nyc.gov. If everything works, then you're ready to get out on the road. Picking up a passenger who uses a wheelchair. When picking up a passenger who uses a wheelchair, you have a couple of options. You can take a request from your driver information monitor, or you can also take a street hail. In this video, we will cover what happens when you accept a request from your driver information monitor or a smartphone app. But remember, you're required to take street hail and accessible dispatch trips. Not accepting these trips is a service refusal, just like refusing to pick someone up based on where they live or how they look. When you get to your destination, press Arrive on your monitor. Exit the car and greet the passenger by name to make sure you have the right person. Stop. Now let's try that scenario again. But this time, let's say you arrive and don't see the passenger. Here's how you should proceed if your rider is a no-show. First, call your passenger's phone number using the number on your driver information monitor. If there's no response, call your support line using the Help Call phone number on your driver information monitor. Be sure to wait the required time shown on the screen. But if your passenger doesn't come, you may still get an extra payment for your time, depending on the type of trip. Onboarding, how to open your ramp. We've covered what to do for a no-show passenger. So let's move on to what to do next after greeting and confirming it is your passenger. Next step, open the ramp. It only takes a short amount of time to complete with these simple steps. Step 1, use the car ignition key to release the shoulder belts. Step 2, pull the yellow handle on the trunk bumper to release the tailgate. Step 3, push down the headrests and fold all the seats down. Step 4, pull the lower seat straps and fold the seats forward. Step 5, use the ramp handhold to pull the ramp out. Make sure to lay it flat or stand on the ramp to flatten it. Now you're ready to help your passenger. How to onboard and secure a passenger who uses a wheelchair. Before helping your passenger into the vehicle, be sure to always ask them how they want to be helped. And only touch or push the wheelchair if the passenger requests that you do so. Now stop. When communicating with your passenger, it is very important to use respectful, person-first language that acknowledges the person first and their disability second. You can say, person who uses a wheelchair. Do not say, wheelchair passenger or wheelchair bound. Also, never say, handicapped or crippled. Always speak directly to the passenger and not to their companion or aide. Okay, now that you know the do's and don'ts of communicating with your passenger, let's move on to onboarding. Press the front retractor release button. Then, pull out the front floor securements. Remember that not all wheelchairs are the same. Always secure the hook to the frame and never to the footrest, armrest, or the wheels. It is okay to ask the passenger where to place the securements. Hook the front floor securements to a solid part on the frame of the wheelchair. This keeps the wheelchair and passenger safe and secure. Now that your securements are attached correctly, let's move on. If the passenger asks for help, roll the wheelchair up the ramp. Always stand behind the wheelchair. Once the passenger is safely inside the vehicle, ask the passenger to lock their brakes, if the wheelchair has brakes. Some wheelchairs do not have brakes, so make sure you're extra careful when attaching the securements. Press the front retractor release button. Next, hook the rear floor securements to the back frame of the wheelchair. the securements should make a 45-degree angle with the floor. To make sure the wheelchair is secure, ask the passenger to unlock the wheelchair brakes and ask if you can gently push and pull on the wheelchair to make sure the securements are tight. Then, ask the passenger to lock the brakes. Remember to tell the passenger what you are doing or let them test the securements themselves. Now that the wheelchair is secure, take the lap belt out of storage and attach it to the rear floor securements. Before attaching the shoulder belt to the lap belt, ask permission before you reach across the passenger. After you ask, connect the shoulder and lap belt. Remember to let the passenger buckle themselves and help if the passenger requests it. It's very important to tell the passenger what you are doing so they know what to expect. Finally, lift and fold the ramp to vertical position until the tailgate latches. Shake the gate slightly to make sure it's locked. Then close the doors. And now you're ready to go. Ask for the destination if you don't already have it, and start the trip. Remember, you should only start the meter once the passenger is safely secured in the vehicle. Now for some key tips. Always say what you're doing to the passenger before you do it. This is an easy way to give great customer service, and it makes a difference. Know your vehicle's equipment, and don't be afraid to ask about the passenger's mobility equipment. Remember, the passenger is the expert with their wheelchair, just as you are the expert with the equipment in the vehicle. Don't rush. Make sure you go through each step so that the passenger is safe and secure. During the trip, be sure to drive safely because the passenger will feel any sharp turns or bumps taken too quickly. Use all four floor securements and the lap belt and shoulder belts to make sure the passenger and wheelchair are safe and secure. Complete these steps for every passenger and wheelchair. Now, let's look at how to onboard a passenger who transfers into a vehicle seat. Some people who use wheelchairs may want to sit inside the vehicle, and it is their right to do so. Other passengers may use walkers. If you're picking up a passenger who uses a walker or who would like to transfer from their wheelchair into a vehicle seat, follow these steps. Start by asking if and how the passenger needs help. But be sure not to touch or take the walker or wheelchair without asking. Next, guide the passenger to the back seat and offer your arm to support them while they move to the seat. Remember, some passengers may need help getting into the vehicle while others can do so on their own. Always ask the passenger how best to help them. Next, ask if the passenger needs you to help them with the seatbelt. Then, ask where they want you to put their wheelchair or walker. And be careful when storing it. Remember, when you're driving a non-wheelchair accessible vehicle, you can still pick up passengers who use wheelchairs. Many passengers can transfer from their wheelchair and into a vehicle seat, so don't refuse passengers using wheelchairs, even if you are driving a non-accessible vehicle. Dropping off a passenger who uses a wheelchair. When you get to your destination, stop your meter. Then, do all the steps you did before to secure the passenger, but in the reverse order. Remember, You should stop the meter when you get to the destination, even if you are not getting the payment until the passenger is safely out of the vehicle. First, pull the yellow handle on the rear bumper. Lower the bumper, then lower the ramp. Disconnect the shoulder and lap belts, and detach the lap belt from the rear floor securement. Ask the passenger to engage their brakes before removing the rear floor securements. If they need help with the brakes, be sure to help them. Next, unhook the rear floor securements and store them in the side compartments. Then, press the front retractor release button to release the front floor securements. Ask the passenger to release their brakes and help them if they need it. Then, carefully guide the passenger down the ramp. One more time, ask the passenger to engage their brakes before removing the front floor securements. If they need help with the brakes, be sure to help them. Ending the trip. Now you're ready to end your trip. After helping the passenger out of the vehicle, position them near the credit card machine. If there is bad weather outside, ask the passenger if they want to pay before leaving the car. Next, ask the passenger how they will pay. If they're paying with a credit card, ask if they need help with payment. It is your responsibility under TLC rules to help passengers pay. Next, ask the passenger if they would like a receipt. Then, ask the passenger if they would like additional assistance. Finally, lift the seats and headrests back to their upright position. Push the ramp back in. Lift the bumper back up. Put your securements and belts in a secure place. Press the front retractor release button so the light goes off. And close the back doors. Don't forget to reconnect the seatbelt in the back seat. Now you're ready to move on to your next trip. You now know how to properly pick up and drop off passengers with disabilities. This process will help you save time and money. As you become more comfortable with all the steps, it should take you only a few minutes to complete. Happy driving!